PL's a very good matchup versus the Viper because you have a natural way to be able to purge off any of the poison attacks. Paimon might be in trouble again. They know he TP'd Baxter. This time they will have no cheeky play from the Enchantress. He's going to look to do as much damage as he can to maybe set up for Gabby to get a return kill. But Jing recognizing this and he gets out of range here to allow Enryu to get the kill. But Dai, they have their hard camp available as well. Looks like Cuckoo's still got a couple creeps that he has to be worried about at the moment. Initially to start though, like Carly is still very much struggling versus the Templar Assassin. There's a big loss hit advantage, Avatar mode, 27-4 compared to the 18-10. So levels honestly is nothing too crazy just because more than likely.
A bit low up here.
It's actually gonna look to turn on Enryu. Maybe Wymon's also in trouble as well. Doesn't have any creeps to play with. Enryu's going to play the distance, allowing Jing to take a majority of the damage. Just have those range attacks flurrying from afar. So that's twice now with bangers. Yeah, they're giving over to the Bane.
Though. Look at it. Oh, the jukes. Oh, bang. What a god.
He had the ward advantage. Hang on. Oh, now you leave Aster alone. So who's the god now? Zephyr's Larson. All right, you're away from the lane. This puts Aster. Oh, he didn't.
He blocked him with a tree.
Oh, no. Wait, was that Zephyr or Ember? Free 59 gold, I'll take that any day of the week. And Dire, they haven't blocked up any of the Ancients. You know, one Ancient, the hard camp as well, so Radiant Triangle unaffected as Carl. Push back way to Radiant's higher ground. He's going to try and turn it, just drop the Meteor, but a Bang instantly cancels this. Zephyr's looking to get involved as well. Do they have the damage to bring down Carl? They do. A long-range attack from Abaddon Mode along with the Bane's assistance. We'll trade at least a one-for-one, and I mean, Neon, you're happy with that trade considering it was your position two for the support.
Radiant structures Aster are fortified.
It's got some assistance coming over. And Zephyr's in a lot of trouble here. Trying to make this cute attempt, but a Bang and Aster secure the kill, and now they're looking over mid for Enryu. A TP in to try and answer Wymon. Carl's gonna give him a little bit of breathing room at the moment, but it still looks like the Enchantress should end up dying. There's no way Wymon gets away. Okay, he does. Very nicely played from Carl.
Got the single point in the Nature's Attendance. Still no point in the Ice Path on Cuckoo, which I'm a
Jing
little concerned about.
That's an aggressive roll. You've got Enryu standing nearby, but nothing really that the Viper can do leading up into three heroes on Dire. Snap of the Sanity is getting dropped, doing mixed amounts of damage here. So they're able to stick around, look to turn it. A Bang's come on over, but Carl, with already this maxed out Astral, doing a lot more damage than they were expecting, but still a Bang. I mean, Carl just walked back to the lane instead of trying to escape to the right side. So a Bang finds a free window here to use the Fiend's Grip, and we have it on mode nearby. They are not lacking any damage.
Still in two minds as to what he wants to go. I still think you absolutely need this Maelstrom.
I'm on. Waiting at the Remnant location. Aster's out of mana. Carl's even got a pogo stick on forward as well. And no one's gonna come to save him. Oh man, you miss on the Meteor. Yeah, will not matter though. Okay, nicely done. T1, four heroes here. They're gonna look to smoke instantly, connect to top.
Against an Ember Spirit in particular, right? Like I said, they are lacking a lot of stuns. But if during that very small stun time, you're able to burn his mana out completely, it's not like he can even just look to leave.
Sure stun, Aster. Everybody get the Ice Path afterwards. He is out of range of the Wukongs, but like you said, no mana to reset his position, so there's the mana burn coming to play. Maybe something he wasn't expecting. He kind of stuck around, didn't remnant instantly. And
it's very close to picking up the Witchblade here on Cuckoo. You would have to imagine it's then. But
Lane, well, got a fight breaking out soon. Cuckoo, TPing into the trap location. A Bang's going to make sure he cuts away the potential of the actual save. Great recognition for the Bang. Just making sure there's no possibility. He at least gets the eyes path up before he dies. So the Frenzy Grip's not going to have a long enough duration, but still, they're eyeing up Carl. Zavadar mode prioritizing the back, looking to take care of the outward devourer, and they'll do just that. A two for nothing, and they get the T1 tower. And I mean, if they look towards Roche, there's already a DD there as well, so I wonder if they consider it. That was something you were bringing up, like how you were going to scale, whether it was a winning lane for the OD or not, depending on his Meteor timing as Cuckoo. Four hit down from a DD Templar Assassin. They committed pretty goddamn deep, though. Gabby's going to look to try and bring down the Bane before the TP out. It would be successful, and now they'll turn over to the Templar Assassin. An overcommitment just for the position three to Kira, and they will be penalized. Everyone on T1 is still farming at a rapid rate, so they will not fall too far behind. As Enryu I know the BKB is on cooldown. We'll be up in 5 seconds, actually. So they're going to bring him down pretty fast before the BKB is back and available. Or Jing rotates in too. Kicks him away from the Macropie. Now gives Henry an opportunity to pop the BKB. He'll cancel the TP on Wymon. Now they'll look over to the Jakiro as well as all of Neon's goons show up to protect the Viper. Now they're still going to be cautious how deep they make the attempt with Carl. Looking to put some revenge on the board. Ascended is not enough to secure the kill. Jin gonna sacrifice his life, but the rest of Neon, they're still not in fighting shape. As Gabby rips apart the Viper now. They are looking for more. They're gonna be cautious. Both sides respecting the damage. For this next team fight, BKB along with double damage rune for Avatar mode. See, T1 edging up across the map. It's only Jin in Avatar mode. Not the rest of Neon are behind the core. He's able to get the blink away to the western side. So it looks like Jing's just going to be the sacrifice here as Neon give up the Earth Spirit. They're going to make sure they don't bleed any more kills though. Got a little bit of glimpse of a bang. Going to make sure he runs away from the team. Although the team is still looking to connect. Can they take the fight? Almost two hits the OD. Ashelot, but he's still in trouble. A blink down to the southern side, but they're still hunting Carl as Enryu tries to lock onto the OD, but they don't have a way to gap close at the moment with the Wukong's out. I mean, Monkey's going to end up falling through the BKB duration, but still they got a big issue in the PL. Gabby starting to rack up the damage here. Still going to double down. Jing's able to lock on top of the Phantom Lance at the moment as well. Carl gives him some breathing room with the Ashel, but he shouldn't be able to make it away. Slide of fist to the last second. Jing's following up for more, but my oh my, what was looking like a rough fight here for Neon. They buy back on one and just answer the call for that skirmish.
Why did it need more? Why did it need more, man? Still a little bit too far away on the OD, unfortunately. Could maybe afford to buy the Ogre Axe instead of the Windlace, just to enable your survivability for that little bit longer. It does feel that they're kind of burst focused right now. On
the north, who they found? Double Meteor to start. They can hold back Jing as well. Castle in trouble. Arcan Pied up to the high ground. Gabby's in the midst of it all, though. They've already killed off Jing. A real wasted BKB from Enryu. He's going to look to try and TP up. The damage, Gabby, not enough. Nice read of that TP. Zefrovi jumps on four, but still, the Boundless Strike is on cooldown.
They're not being very clean how they're looking to make a lot of these movements here on T1.
I mean, they're smoked as well. They want to take the fight. Restless in the backpack. Defar. I got confirmation he's there. How do you chain lock down the Ember? Well, they won't have the opportunity. If BKB, as Aztec goes flying to the middle, but Cuckoo once again is going to get brought down to start the fight until Carl swings over the tree line, gets the Astral safe, and now they need a way to the answer the Fiend's Grip. Gabby has got a silence thanks to the Mindbreaker, so they'll get rid of the Fiend's Grip, but still the rest of Neon, they're in trouble as Gabby's damage. Too much for them to handle. They'll kill off the Ember. Avatar mode to the northern side. He's not the target at the moment. It's actually going to be Enryu. They do have a ward nearby and seeing T1 posturing around the area, but well, I'll tell you what, Roshi's gone and there's no way to counteract this. Jesus, Whitemon?
Let's throw this four.
TA's in trouble. Can he get the blink away? Not going to be fast enough. Now the refraction's getting burnt away as Gabby's locking on top of the Templar Assassin. A Hurricane Pike up to the higher ground. Still Cuckoo's the main target at the moment for Neon. They've got the real PL. They need a way to cancel the Fiend's Grip, but bang, the full duration lockdown. Is it going to be enough? First life cancelled out, and Neon, now they've got an ankle to take this second round. Going to back off. Reset. Avatar mode, a blink away. He's got Aston nearby. They are lacking some mana, though. So maybe feeling like they're happy with that initial round, and if they can just reset and not lose any more. And I think that's going to be the case. Bang. Well, maybe not a bang, though. All right, you lose the Bane. You're happy with that. Oh, no. Jing, don't reveal his position with the car. He's just run there and the illusion sees him. Well, they see him. Oh, Carl, nice jump in. All right, losing two supports now. They're going to start to connect now. Templar Assassin TPing to the fight. Fool.
They could easily just look to claim this T1 tower on the top side. The other thing as well is that we're seeing another one of these, I believe, 0% win rate items, at least in the games that we've watched, with the Wraith pack being built up by
Zephyr.
Yeah.
Starts to find on a bang. Force to the low ground. Emery follows suit as well. Avatar mode still wants to take the fight, but the Abyssal reveal from Gabby might be a bit of an issue as Avatar mode, he's got no way to reset his position. Hurricane Pie fast enough, it's not. TA down, godlike streak claim, and now Carl looking on for more. in between the T2, T3 tower, but there's no way to escape as they blocked off the high ground retreat. So the Monkey King's going to be the target. Jing and Enryu looking to stand their ground, but the buyback's starting to rain in from Neon. Can they turn this fight back around as Gabby is the raid boss? PL well and truly an issue at this stage in the game. The dieback for the Bane, Gabby's out, and those buybacks feel not worth it at all. You're sitting in T1 slot before the game started, and feels like they've got, no, I don't want to say the last laugh, but definitely in a position to be the case. Cuckoo's damage continuing to ramp up. It's still a question of his positioning in fights. The past couple of fights, it's been a lot better. You know, maybe this is because how strong PL is, and he can just brute force in and not really care. Asta? Does he get away? Doesn't have any remnants available. There's the initial stun. Sanity is dropped, and there's those cars point. It just took a little bit longer for the remnants to be utilized here, and
probably don't get that kill. It'll take an extra right click to be able to take him out, but actually doing so, and it's even going to be a nice thing to
Avatar
do.
Avatar mode. I shall start. Cuckoo follow. Radiant's
top tower. Under attack. Oh,
doesn't force down. He's still got Aegis, BKB. Jin's gonna try and commit the first life. Nice kickback as well. So if Karl dies in this position, this actually could be a decent start for Neon. He's able to blink away to the mid tier 3 tower. Now it's closer to at least tier 1 so they can protect him on the respawn. The Ember's forced to buy back. Earthspirit down for 60, but he's got a buyback as well. Horror is getting reined in. Bloodthorn for Enryu. Nullify for Avatar mode. Wide miss for this defense. Let's see how they can hold though. Try and start refraction force, double force staff away. So the Wukong's is going to be wasted here. And Asta though jumps the middle. It's going to be cautious. Abyssal out. It's still got the opportunity to reset. How do you take this fight now for Neon? It's going to be Jing. Jing's how you start this. He's really been making the plays throughout this entirety of the game. Going to start on the Phantom Lancer. Is Gabby really killable though? I don't know. PL is such a raid boss. He turns to blow up the Earth Spirit. Jing, that's a dieback for him. It's an Isolation Fiend's Grip from a Bang. They're going to be able to cancel off the life of the Monkey King as well, but they've still got issues. But PL, Gabby going on forward for more. Deeper and deeper inside the base. Three down, no buybacks. Now they look onto the tier 4 tower. And when it was an even game for majority of this game one, Phantom Lancer started to get out of control, and I don't see a way back in here. Maybe Avatar mode can make something happen. Still, the TA is doing ridiculous amount of damage, but this Abyssal Blade from Gabby was where it really all turned around from there as the G's are dropped. And it's going to be T1 taking out game one victory.
It was just the inevitable thing that we were talking about, right? Like, you were always going to get to this stage where the PL was unkillable. So much needed to be put on to Asta to be able to make the plays happening early on.
I feel like the lanes is where this game's going to be determined, so I'll give the edge to T1.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the one worry potentially is, right, like, what do you have that's going to stop this,
And Ryu?
Like, Enchantress could potentially just run away, right?
Yo, we're both right, Denon, come on. Give me a high five.
Yeah, and both of them honestly want to do that. They either want to stand and right-click, or they want to chase people down, and both teams, I'd say T1, probably have the slight edge with a lot of the slow abilities.
Starting to stack up the poison. Wyman's already got level 2 as well, so that is enough to secure the kill. And another one to Enryu's Broodmother, so really struggling in this bottom lane.
And then just be ridiculously efficient. I don't know. I'm almost never a fan these days of Battle Furiosa, just because there are so many other heroes.
He's dead here. Yeah, Boundless into one. All right, let's see. What's the play, T1? Zephyr's going to do the job. Oh, he's going to run back into the Primal. Oh, no, Zephyr big brains the Ursa. All right, Zephyr does it. He no help. He'll do it himself. Every game, I just remind myself at how ridiculously talented these pro players are, making moves like that. I thought he was 100% dead. And now you've seen a rotation top, so now it makes it that much more difficult for Enryu. Solo versus the two heroes, he's gonna die again!
Oh my god, the prediction god coming through. I'll step down from my throne.
Alright, mid lane. Rana needs to get on the backside here to set up for the arrow with the range creep position. Jing will do just that.
We're even going to look to rotate down avatar mode here towards the bottom side. The Observer Ward just expired as well, that was placed in the lane super early on by Whitemon. So maybe they'll catch out Gabby.
Well, it has to be a deep dive attempt. Oh, the avalanche just out of range of the Fiend's group. Whitemon will still tape in, so he's able to cancel a decent amount of the duration, but they still have issues with how much damage to Lesh is really starting to ramp up at this stage in the game. As Carl TP's through, drops the Sonic Wave, clipping onto multiple heroes, but still the Broodmother has been untouched this team fight, getting a double down bottom. Pick off into Roche they're looking for. Gabby the target. The rest of the team smoke next to Gabby. They started to evacuate away from the area. Now they can look to move back.
I know.
Ass has already started on Roche though. Does he look to continue making the play? No, it's going to leave the pit as a bang. It's the first casualty. Zephyr's still moving on forward for avatar mode.
They see this TP coming through here and Whitemon should know that that was happening. So get out in
time. Asta's under a radiant sentry. It's about to expire, but they've got so much value out of it before it does. Orc it out. No threat of the rage. Bye-bye, Ursa. Blown up. He's kicking himself. Of course, we have this bird's eye perspective, but he would have been able to kill Roshan and then get out for it. The bang? That's a Fiend's grip. This is Cuckoo as well. First step of the game for the Enchantress, and still a big kill nonetheless with how solid of a lane Cuckoo did have.
Yeah, of course. You definitely need to transition it, though, especially once you've got the Orc.
Pick off after pick off. Let's go, baby. Shadow Demon's gone. They're eyeing up Carl. So the rest of T1, though. They need to move over the pit pretty fast, though. Roshi's starting to fall. It's going to be Zephyr's job. Can he steal it? Oh, the arrow! Jing! Gives Asa the opportunity. Pick up the Aegis. Now leap on forward for more for another kill. What's a backline? They've slept up Gabby. Wyman's going to try and TP in to provide him some assistance. In fact, it's going to hold back Asta instead. But Gabby's able to retreat away from the area. Of course, it will cost Wyman his life. Time what? A Ben? He's in no man's land.
It's a pretty deep dive, but I mean, it does accomplish a lot, right?
Still eyeing up Enryu. Now to finish meal. Enryu's pretty goddamn speedy, though.
Nice ward from Arbeck.
Oh, now
Wyman.
Well. I mean, Wyman's just going to be picked off, and a bang. And the rest of the goons are looking at TP3. Now Cuckoo's in trouble as well. Carl's going to look to try and cancel this with the Orc, and he's able to do so, but Cuckoo's already taken the full brunt of the damage. Avatar mode's still going to be cautious, but with the help of Enryu, they can just step on inside the ring, bring down the monkey, and now eyeing up Carl, but a quick blink away to the tree line. He's okay. Man, Neon excelling through the mid game, and they're looking really good. I understand. I see where you're coming from. But Carl says, we're going the late game. You see this little bit of net worth in front of me? That gets me to my next item. Enryu? Haste. Renu gonna try and take the fight around the higher ground, but like you said, they don't have the Sonic Wave for that full burst. He runs back into the arrow. Wyvern needs to try and help the Queen of Pain, but Wyvern completely avoids a saving aspect to potentially turn this fight back around, as now it's a disaster for T1. Gabby, I mean, standing with Zephyr. The Wukongs is anchoring some portion of this fight. Just gonna try and get it out to safety with the Shadow Blade, but the rest of Neon homing. Make sure there is no retreat for the Tiny. Four down, and they have no casualties at all. He was able to get involved through the early fights, which gave you this 5-on-5 potential and just a way to get early Roche, which was something you needed, as Cuckoo's still going to go down. Almost run to the arrow as well. I mean, and they've had big brood issues for a majority of this game now, but
they lost like 3 tier 2 towers as a result of not having a Queen of Pain for a very key team fight where they had vision. So everything was set up for Carl to have. Like, that was his level 2 Sonic Wave as well, so it's a lot of damage.
So Roche was being claimed at the same time. A bang?
Yep.
You're on to Gabby. He could be available. Maybe if Dara have gone too deep, they don't have the Ursa to connect just yet. And now Bane's gone. Lesh is gone as well. T1, can they withstand the Broodmother pushing on to even out the trade? Enryu continuing to beat onto Gabby, BKB, Scotty. There's seeming to be no escape for the Tiny, but they're going deeper and deeper inside the base. BKB soon to expire for the Orchid. Ticks out the Tiny. Now Carl's going to try and blink out to safety. Just gets away.
What can you do against this Broodmother? Now he's even going for the AC build. You love to see it against this...
against this tiny...
eyeing up the brood. I do not know how they ever kill brood. Dude, Ash is like, thank you, free kills for me. Cuckoo Sans, unable to pummel into them with the impetus. That's still only level 2 at the moment.
For whatever reason, they just continue the dive on forward after the Aegis was claimed. So,
oh, Cuckoo.
Potential to maybe take the tier 3.
Dude, the brood is eyeing up more food. You don't have the easiest stuns to sell for the arrow, but when you've got Skadi along with the Silken Bowler, those slows plentiful to make sure there is no escape. And Gabby's been able to respawn. Let's see how they can take this fight. Of course, keep in mind they've got the Aegis advantage. Let's see, Gabby, you're going to stick around. Andrew's able to pop the BKB. They'll just turn to blow up Zephyr. Oh, boy.
They can't do it without Sonic Wave, right? Like, even just the smaller things like...
Abeng's waiting the wings as well. He's ready with this Fiend's Grip. I don't care, though. Objective-based gaming. They still don't have the 5 members on T1 to make this defense. And how do you start the fight on it to end Ryu? I mean, this brood is ridiculously beefy. So bring down Cuckoo. Carl's able to reposition. Ass is going to be a bit cautious. I'm going to dive under the T4 tower. He's going to respect at least the lineup at T1. And they're not going to be set up now for this high ground defense. They were in a position previously. The Ursa's going to take a lot of damage here with a combo. Enough to get rid of the first life. Can you protect Gabby though? Wyman's going to be in a position. Banishment out to safety. Now Zephyr's going to charge up the Wukongs as well. Carl, nice prioritization. It's going to look to cancel out the life of the Bane, but they've still got issues with the Brood along with the Ursa as well. As Cuckoo still hasn't fallen just yet. They're looking to do their best to kite the Broodmother, but on the backline, Carl bashed up from Asta. Still has a buyback available. Gabby's going to eye up Jing too. Detection nearby, so Gabby's able to lock onto the Mirana. And now it turns back. I don't know, man. Brood's goddamn tanky. 3,800 health. A toss deeper inside the base, and that is the one way they can get it done. Multiple buybacks are going to be expended here for the defense of T1. Can they still take this fight, though? Neon have a huge net worth. Leithen's going to turn it back on Gabby. A split earth into the arrow combination. But Avatar mode, he is lacking mana, so they don't have the way to take away the life of Gabby. 2 gone, make it a 3rd, and now High Ground and Mega Creeps have been defended.
He's got the BKB finally, he had the Wukong set up, and he got the Boundless onto the Bane. I think without all of those three things happening...
He sees Avatar mode, they're going to get positioning Asta. Who's the more valuable kill? Looks like the Lesh track is going to be the one they look to blow up. Still got the BKB along with the Bloodstone. The Lesh is gone now. Asta doesn't have anyone to back him up as well. Hang on a second. What's going on? T1, are they going to find another window back into this game? Ursa can't lock on the Cuckoo. They both don't have buybacks.
Are they close at least? Okay, the Leshrac is 20 gold away.
Losing the one set though, and that's all you can lose. You've got tier 2 top, you got tier 2 bottom.
You think they don't just keep going though?
I think you don't...
Using the haste there, really wants to take away that vision to enable them to have an effective team fight.
They still have the ward on the backline though. This is huge for T1. They haven't dewarded it just yet. Carl's gonna pounce. Eyeing up the Queen of Pain. The Broods are targeting them over from Gabby. They haven't bursted through Enryu. Now if they can get rid of Zephyr before the Wukongs, but it won't even matter. Ends up dying. A 1-for-1 trade. They're locking onto Gabby. A Force. Banishment still all available. But how does he get in range? The grasping jaws of Neon pushing on 4 for more. Tiny goes down. He's got a buyback to rejoin. But now they're going to be eyeing up the Queen of Pain. Bashes galore. Ursa secures the kill. Cuckoo's going to stand his ground. But he doesn't have the damage.
Oh, not even the Shadow Strike's going to tick him out there at the end. With this few defenders and up against a double Siege Creep Wave with a Leshrac and a Broodmother, that's going to be an easy Mega Creep.
That's potentially game. At least Wymon's with the Tiny. The Banishment to maybe reposition, but BKB's still on cooldown, so it's just going to make it even easier to set up for the Split Earth. As with Gabby goes down, so does the hopes of T1 finding an angle back into this game. For Neon, they will tie the series 1-1, and we are continuing to see T1 struggle in some of these games.